Good evening, dear students. Now, myself, Dr. Vishalchand, here start with the topic introduction of immune system. As you know, immunity is a body ability to resist or eliminate potentially harmful foreign material or abnormal cell. So, as we know, we have a very important protection system is available in our system. That is commonly known as immunity. Immunity is an inborn capacity of the body to eliminate the foreign organism or any type of abnormal cell from the body. So, our body has so many ability to remove these type of the pathogenic component, and this overall phenomena is introduced in a single word. That is immunity. So, in this process, we have to go for the elimination of various components like viruses, toxins, carcinogens, fungus, pollutions, some bacteria, germs, and parasites. So, this all comprises the harmful foreign material or abnormal cells which are responsible for the elimination of these components from the body. Now, immunity history. If we go in some history part of the immunity, then we find out that in 1890, Emil von Behring and Katastro is the first who vaccinated animals from the serum, and this is the first insight of the immunity, how we can get another way of the protection. So in the vaccine, as we know that we have all the type of the different type of the antigenic component are get inserted in your system, and then after they start giving the protection in your body. Similarly, this Emil von Behring and Katastro did the similar phenomena in which they took the serum from the some vaccinated animal and introduced it to the some organism or human system, and ultimately they are get protected from the those specific type of pathogenic component. Another name is that is Metnikoff. In 1880, they started with the another type of the immunity that is known as the cell-based immunity. And now there's one more name, Medicius, and in 1940 they were responsible for the transfer of WBC from immunity for the tuberculosis. Now in these three. In this three different time period, we see that in 1880, 1890, and 1940, three different type of immunological processes were get introduced by these personalities. One is humoral based immunity, another is cell based immunity, and another is the immunity through WBC. So we have so many outcomes will come in different time interval by this personality. So we can get the two major type of immunity, that is the cell-based immunity and the humoral immunity, which antibodies play the major role. Now, both serum and cell contributes to immunity. Immunology is a really very fascinating word, and also the whatever the researcher that goes on in the field of the immunology, they have get the huge prizes. As we see, since 1901. We got the 19 different Nobel Prize in immunology related research. Immunity is the word which is generated from the Latin word immunis, which means state of protection from infectious disease. Now, the immune system. As you all know, the immune system is comprised of the two major components. One is the innate immunity and another is the adaptive immunity. So, in innate immunity, we have this immunity is provided from birth. So all the person who are being get innate immunity, this type of the immunity is already remain in their system from the birth. And there are so many components are the part of the innate immunity. So first of all, we discuss about the some major components which are get involved in this immune system. Not an immune system is not an organic system. It is a complex system which includes so many components. that are skin, skin that is the physical barrier. Then we have a mucous membrane, they are also termed as a physical barrier, secretions, some blood cell and vasculatures, bone marrow, liver, lymphatic system and lymphoid organ, and most tissues. So first of all, we come to this immune system as an overview. So what is immune system actually is? Immune system means the various type of the body component which can involve to provide the immunity in your system, that comprises the immune system. And in this part, there are two major components will come. One is known as the physical barrier and another is known as the internal defense system. So that in the physical barrier, it is similarly work as the soldiers are on front. In front we see that there are so many soldiers are available on front which can do a single process in which they are trying to check the any type of the foreign component which try to enter inside the body or inside the country. So they just check that either that person is from the self country or from some other country or the foreign country. So we have to first of all check it, and then after we allow the entry of those personalities into the system. Similarly, these physical barriers are the components which are responsible for the proper checking, evaluation, and then after try to make the entry of those foreign molecules to be get into the cell body. In which skin is the one of the first physical barrier which is provide the that type of the functioning on site in your body system. Another is mucous membrane. If skin is anyhow get invaded by the some foreign molecule, now it comes inside the skin. There are some very specialized cell system are associated with the skin. They are termed as the M cell or the mucous cell, and they trap those antigenic component inside those mucus and left out from the body. So we have a sebum glands, we have the tears. So these all are the part of the mucous membrane which may be also be act as a physical barrier. Then we have secretions. Secretions have the so many antimicrobial activities. If you see the structure of the microbes, then you find out the microbes are comprised of the two major components. One is the proteinaceous signature and another is that have the genetic component. But the interaction of the microbial component is that occurs with the proteinaceous system. So whenever these type of the secretions start interacting with the microbial component, they have the property to lyse those protein or the carbohydrate or the lipid component of those microbial component and ultimately kill their microbial system which may try to invade your body. So in this way you have to see that yes, have the lysozyme activity, some mucus are there which have the also the antimicrobial components are existing. Another very important, if these physical barriers are get degraded, then the microbial component or any pathogenic component is get entered inside the blood cells, and that is the WBCs are there. The white blood cells are there which can give the cellular life function for the immunity. Then we have a bone marrow where the most of the lymphatic systems are get initiated and now they may start doing their activity. Then liver, which is responsible for the generation of the complement proteins, because the complement proteins are another very important immune cells which may eliminate the pathogenic component from the body by killing them. Lymphatic system, lymphoid organ, and now we have so many resident cells are there. Now, this overall cellular component consists of the following activity. They have defense against anybody pathogens. They have ability to remove the worn-out cells like RBCs and the tissue debris from injured tissues. Identification and destruction of abnormal and mutant cells. Rejection of foreign cells and inappropriate responses. So how they can we get the defense for against the invading pathogens? As I already told you, there is physical type, antimicrobial activity, and so many other components are there which can provide the defense. Why not sell? As you know that RBC have our major property of the RBC are the one of the carriers of the hemoglobin or the oxygen molecule in your system. But they have a very specific lifespan of 120 days. After the 120 days, these RBC cells should be get removed from the body. And the elimination of these RBC is also being termed as a burnout. So because if it is not get eliminated, then we have the huge number of the RBC that are in the system, it is always to become a problematic site for the body. So that's why we have to eliminate this RBC and the tissue debris. So whenever we get any type of injury or the disease, then so many tissues are getting damaged or killed, and we have to remove these tissue debris from the body. So all of this function is comes into the immunity. Identification and destruction of abnormal and mutant cells, that is another very important part of those this immunological process. Like primarily we have any type of the cancer cell, if it is get converted into the any normal cell is get converted into a cancer cell, then the identification and destruction is also done by the this cell function, that is immunity. When we go for some organ transplantation, then also the self and the non-self discrimination goes on, and that is known as the rejection of foreign self. And some other inappropriate responses like the allergies and autoimmune diseases, it is similar immunity to another functions. So, as we discussed, this is the one of the figure in which you see that so many different types of the foreign molecules are getting made in your system. Now, overview of immune system, that is composed of the innate and adaptive system. First thing, innate is known as the first line of defense. It is totally a non-specific in nature. And adaptive is the second line of defense. It is that is highly specific in nature. And both the immune system is interacting in equal manner for any type of the pathogenic activity which is getting in the immune system. What is happening in the immune response? If we see in the figure, that we find out that in immune response, first of all, we get the innate immunity. And the innate immunity is the one of the most important immunological response, which is rapid in nature. And if the broad range of microbes are getting associated for these innate immunity. We categorize this innate immunity into two ways, like external defenses and the internal defenses. In external defenses, we have skin, mucous membrane, and secretions. Anyhow, if these external defenses are not helpful in the elimination of these foreign molecules, then we come to the next defense, that is the internal defense. And in the internal defense, the phagocytic cells, antimicrobial proteins, inflammatory responses, NK cells, and the complement cells are the another very important component which provide the internal defense. So, the innate immunity is, in summary, we can say innate immunity is one of the most important immunity which is already existing in your body from the birth, and they have a good rapid response. They have covering the huge amount of that pathogenic components, and they may associate with the two major defense system, one is the external and internal defense system. Now we come to the discussion of the first type of the defense, that is external defenses. Before that, we have a comparative analysis between the both of these two, innate and adaptive immunity. Innate, that as I say, that it is the first line of defense, and adaptive is the second line of defense. In immunity, no time lag is getting there. And in adaptive immunity, there is a time lag. Not antigen specific. Innate immunity is totally non-specific. Whereas adaptive immunity is antigen specific. There is no memory is generated in the case of innate immunity. And in the adaptive, we have the development of memory response. Now, external defense. So, these are some pictures which show the external defense, in which first the skin. Skin is one of the most important part of the body which can provide the external defense with their anatomical features. The epidermis, the skin is comprised of the three major components, that is the epidermis, dermis, and hypodermis, in which we see that the dermis part is get connected with the one very important component that is known as sebaceous gland. And this sebaceous gland are the one of the most important glands which are responsible for the release of sebum. And what these sebums can do? Sebum is the basically a type of the mucus component which is always we get released from the body, and they try to eliminate or capture the pathogenic component directly from the skin side. Another is mucociliary skeletus. So our overall this anatomical values is get associated with the mucociliary escalator that we go for the flip-flap action inside these vessels. And what they can do, whenever any type of the pathogenic component can come inside these type of trap, ultimately as you can floor your just you can clean your floor by having the some floor brooms, ultimately the similar way in our system, these cells are specialized for the release of any type of pathogenic component with those flip-flop movement from the affected from the invading pathogen in our system. Now we have another type of these anatomical variants which are associated with the specific organs like eyes, some genitourinary organs like urine, tears, saliva. These all are the components which are carried out the flushing action of the pathogenic component. Now, some other chemical factors, like before this we have to see the anatomical variant which are the mechanical in nature. Here is the some anatomical variant which are the chemical in nature, like antimicrobial property which are available in the peptides in sweat. So sweating is another very important phenomenon of immunity in your body. As you know, whenever we have go for the high amount of temperature that rises outside of your body, ultimately we get the huge sweating. This is just because they can clean the pores of your skin. If any type of the pathogen component is trying to invade this pore through skin, then we have the huge amount of sweating is get released, and this sweating may cause the clearance of the pathogenic component from those pores. And these sweats are actually contain some peptides which are responsible for that any type of proteinaceous molecule should be denatured immediately. Another chemical component is your gastric acid, that is the HCl in the stomach, which having the very low pH, that is up to 1, and this pH is responsible for the killing of or neutralization of any type of the biomolecular component which are existing inside your gut. Lysozyme, which is another very important enzyme which is available in the tears, they are similar functions because they have the some antimicrobial activity, they have the denaturing peptides are there. So these type of the components are existing, chemical component are existing in the tears, which helps in the removal of these pathogenic component. Saliva is another very important component which is associated in the in your mouth, and then maybe first line of defense is provided by the and whenever we have any type of food components are having. And this is after the mixing with the food component, they try to kill the pathogenic component directly inside the mouth. Now some biological factors. If we see the biological factors, then we see the organs which are associated with the biological factor are the basically the our body openings. So what are those openings are? We see that we have a few numbers of the openings are there in through which these pathogenic components are trying to enter inside the body. First is your nostrils. Nostrils are the one of the very important organs through which we can be carried out a process of inhale and exhale. And in this process, what we do, the most of the airborne bacterial component that can enter inside the body through nostrils. So nostrils are get associated with the specialized type of that immune system. They are termed as NALT, that is nasal associated lymphoid tissue. Now another very important opening of your body, just beneath the nostrils, are mouth. We have get the water, we have get the food and other components through mouth in our body. So the mouth is another opening through which this pathogenic component try to enter inside the body. And this mouth is another aspect, also we get associated with another biological factor that are known as the, that is GALT, and that is commonly termed as GALT, and that is gut associated lymphoid tissue. Now then we have a lungs, and this is another get associated with some another type of the lymphoid tissue that are known as the, that is buccal associated lymphoid tissue, that is BALT. Then we have another mucus associated lymphoid tissue, MALT, that are the part of your urinary genital organs, and that is another type of the opening which are available in the body. So by these different opening components like nostril, mouth and the urogenital organs, they may get associated with the so many lymphoid tissue, they are termed as the biological factor. Another important component of this is the flora. The different type of the species which are available, the bacterial species are available in our body, they are also be helpful in to, providing the immunity in the body. Some pathogens are compete with the another pathogenic component with their nutrient and stresses, and in this way they can be helpful in the providing the immunity. Like stomach, colon, intestine are the similar biological components. Now, internal defense, as we see that external defense, in the external defense we have to see that biological factor, chemical factor and the mechanical factors. Now in the internal defense, the first component is our WBC. Now if you go through the separation of the different type of immune cells through the blood system, then one phenomenon you have to carry out, in which what you have to do, you took out the blood from any of the person and add the phycoagent in the blood and centrifuge it. And after the centrifugation of 15 to 20 minutes, then you find out the three different layers in that that centrifuge tube. And in these three layers are the first is RBC. You can see the percentage of RBC in the blood is up to 45%. Then the second layer is buffy coat, and this buffy coat is composed of WBC and platelets. And the third layer is of plasma, which percentage is up to 55%. So the overall blood is composed of these three components. One is RBC, another is WBC, and third is plasma. The concentration of plasma is huge, that is 55%. Second most available concentration is that is of RBC, that is 45%, and third is WBC, which is composed of that buffy coat, that is composed of the WBC and the platelets. Now, plasma consists of three very important components that are also known as 3C, that is complement proteins, coagulation proteins and cytokines, and they are responsible for the extracellular defense. Okay, so now the majorly the cells which are responsible for the internal defense are the WBC and the these 3C component, that is cytokines, coagulation proteins and the complement protein. So you can see WBC is a totally separate part, and these 3C component is the part of plasma, and all of them are providing the that internal defense. Now, we come to the WBC. So, if you go through the detail of the WBC, then you find out WBC is composed of these five different types of the cell. One is monocyte, another is eosinophils, lymphocyte, neutrophils, and the basophils. If you see the structure, then you have to get the difference of all of these cells on the basis of the type of the granules which are available inside the these different cell components. So monocytes are also termed as big eaters, and they are converted into the, after the maturation, it is converted into the macrophages. It is the big granular component. If you go through the eosinophils, then you have find out eosinophils have the bilobed granule components are existing. In neutrophils, you have to see that the multilobed granular components are available, and in basophils there is no granules are there. There is a very small, very small grain-like components are existing. Then we come to the lymphocyte. So lymphocyte are the cells which are basically responsible for the generation of three different types of the cell component. One is the B cell, another is T cell, and the NK cells. So these different types of cells are responsible for the generation, that adaptive type of immune response, but they are originated from the lymphocytes. Now, as I already told you that monocytes are what? Monocytes are the specialized cells which are then converted into the macrophages after the maturation. Basophils are the other specialized cells which are finally then converted into a mast cells. Now we come to the one of the most important innate immune cell that is known as neutrophils. So neutrophils are most abundant WBC. The percentage of this cell is about 50 to 60% in the cell system. And what the function they can do? They are getting out the phagocytosis process, and they are efficient phagocytes. Most important cell of the innate immune system. So, if you see that in the case of the innate immunity, one of the very important function of the phagocytosis is done by the these specialized type of the cell that are the neutrophils. And they are available in a huge amount and carried out the that phagocytosis phenomena. What is meant by phagocytosis? Phagocytosis means to eat cell. Phago means to eat, and cyto means to cell. So phagocytosis is the phenomena in which these specialized cells are able to eat the cells. And WBC carrying the huge amount of the neutrophils, and the function of these neutrophils are find, eat, and digest microbes. So this is what the role of these neutrophils in your system. They have the ability to find the some pathogenic component, eat them, and whatever the chemical components are existing inside these phagocytic cells, they digest these microbes also. Now this picture shows how the phagocytosis activities get done by this neutrophil cell. In the first, you can see that what happens in the first process, the chemotaxis and adherence of the microbe to phagocyte. So anyhow, whenever the microbes are comes into the system, these neutrophil like cell try to capture these pathogenic component or the microbial component directly by adhering on their surface. As soon as they can adhere on the surface, they create a pore for them. In the second process, after the creation of the pore, they ingest the microbe by the phagocyte, and then they can form the phagosome, in which the microbe is get captured. The phagosomes are known as the phagocytic vesicle. And then after, in the fourth step, the fusion of phagosome is get occurred with the lysosomes, to form the phagolysosome. So the enzymes and other chemical components which are existing in the lysosomes are trying to digest the ingested microbe in that phagolysosome, and then there is a formation of some residual body containing the indigestible material, and they are get discharged as a waste material out of the body. And some partially digested microbes are always be get expressed on the surface of these phagocytic cells, and then that is how the phagocytic cells are acting like a antigen presenting cell. Sorry. So lysosomes are the that component which carries the granule, and that granules are the digestive enzymes. So what is the granules? So granules are the lysozymes that digest the bacterial cell wall and other antimicrobial proteins. Additional role of the neutrophils. So as I said, that whenever the some partially digested microbes are there, and it is not completely digested by the lysosomic component. Now those peptidal components are get expressed on the surface of these phagocytic cell with the help of the MHC molecule, and that is whenever get expressed on the surface, now that is known as antigen presenting cell. This, so these phagocytic cell are also be act as a antigen presenting cells. And what they do, whenever these antigen presenting cells are there, they are trigger the inflammatory responses. Now we come to another very important cell that are termed as monocytes. So monocytes are another very important cells which are available in your system. Other than the these neutrophils, the percentage of these monocytes are very low. It is around 5%, which is available in the WBC. But they are migrating into the tissue and become macrophages. So if you see the difference between the phagocytic cell like the neutrophil and the monocyte, then the one major difference you find between both of these two phagocytic cells are, neutrophils are the cells which are the phagocytic cell available in your blood. So the part of the phagocytic cell which is available in the blood are neutrophils, which is the part of the cell which are phagocytic in tissues, they are the macrophages. So on the basis of the maturation of these monocytes into the different part of the your tissue cell, they are we get different names also. Like when the monocytes get matured into the lung, it is termed as alveolar macrophages. When they are we get matured into the bone, it is termed as osteoclasts. When they are we get matured in some other tissues, they are known as histiocytes. Whenever they are matured in liver, they are termed as Kupffer cell. In the brain, they are termed as microglia. And when it is get matured in the intestine, they are termed as intestinal macrophages. So in this way, we see the different category of the macrophages are get available into the different tissue part, and all of them have a similar nature that they have get from go for the phagocytic activity. Macrophages are termed as the big eaters because they have the huge property of the binding, eating, and the killing of the microbes, microbial component. They are also be acting as antigen presenting cell like the neutrophils are. Another type of the immune cell which are most important in providing the immunity or providing the that killing action of the some pathogenic component, they are termed as NK cell or the natural killer cells. So as like the B and T lymphocyte, natural killer cells are not those cells which are responsible for the specific binding to a pathogenic molecule and the killing of them, but they are totally non-specifically responsible for the binding and the killing of cells. These are the important part of immune system. They are responsible for the kill virus, bacteria and other infected cells. Those are the intracellular pathogens, and they are also responsible for the killing action of cancer cells. So in this animation you can see how the killing action by these natural killer cells can be done. First of all, they ask any cell for their history. If it is a virus infected cell or the cancer cell or the bacterial cell, the killer cell at once terminate those cancer cell or other infected cell by if it didn't get the phenotype of the previous history of any host cell. So this is what another animation you can see, that in the case of NK cells, differentiate between the cell choose to kill. If some ill-infected cells or normal cells are existing, like the B cell and other cells come, so they come, natural killer cells come and they say that, hey, nice to meet you, and likewise, and then after they have a good interaction between the cells, and so they never be get any type of action against those cells. But if any infected cell there comes, then they ask for the some specific type of identification, representation. If they are unable to give that proper identification and representation to the NK cell, so NK cell at once kill those infected cells whenever that some surface proteins are not available on their cell surface. And this has happened in the case of the cancer or the viruses infection, that some specific type of receptors are totally shed off from the surface, and which may be responsible for the type of the representation that these cells are become an infected cell, or the cells are getting converted into the cancer line. Now, in this picture you can see that NK cell recognizes MHC1 molecule from the healthy cells and does not kill it. And if any infected cell that doesn't have the MHC class 1 molecule on their surface, NK cell at once start releasing the granule with perforin and proteases, and they kill both host cell and the microbe. So, in the action of the NK cells, we see that the host cell is also get killed with the microbial component, and this is how the NK cells may be responsible for the getting their action. So TLRs, that is another very important transmembrane proteins which are available on the surface of macrophages, which may responsible for the function, like they can be trying to be proper identification and the killing action of the pathogenic component or the newer microbial component which comes into your system. Another word which is very important for the TLRs, they are conserved across vertebrates. So what is mean by the conserved across vertebrates? That means these TLRs are, when we generated, they are remain as such in the simpler species. If we are the Homo sapiens sapiens, then we have a very common TLR which is available from our ancestors to present time. In the similar way, the TLRs which are available in some other animal species, they are equally similar with that TLRs which are available into their own species. And it is another part of the innate immune system. So what they do, TLRs, the toll-like receptor, what the function of these TLRs are? They look out for microbes or their components. They bind to the microbes or their components. They trigger a cascade of event to kill or protect against pathogen. So the two major what are the functions that TLRs can do? The first is they look for the microbes, they bind with microbes, and after the binding, they trigger a series of events that kill or protect the body from these pathogenic components, and they are innate immune sensors. Now in this animation you can see these are the TLRs which are available on the cell surface of the macrophages, and you can see that they have the binoculars in your hand, they have to get wirelesses. So in this way, what they are doing the that they are searching from the microbes or the pathogenic component around them, and if they can find out any type of the pathogenic component or the microbe around them, they send the alert to the other cells also, so that this part of the body or this cell of the body is getting infected. So you have to get some start initiating the some responses to protect against these type of the pathogenic components. There is another function of TLR, they can bind the microbes. So in this way, after whenever they can find out the microbes are in their surroundings, they can, after the find out, they can bind with them, and after the binding, they can start the process of elimination. So these are the some of the TLR component which are available. So if you see that yeah, the different type of the TLRs are existing on a different part of the cell surfaces. That in outer membrane of the cell, you can see that TLR1, TLR2, TLR4, and TLR5 are existing, and they have a very unique specificity for the binding of the different type of the components. Like TLR1 is responsible for the binding of bacterial lipopeptides. TLR2 are responsible for the binding of lipoteichoic acids, which are available in the gram-positive bacteria. TLR4 is responsible for the binding of LPS, that is lipopolysaccharides, which is a part of the gram-negative bacteria. TLR5 is the having the specificity for the binding with the flagellin, which is available in the motile bacteria. So in this way, you can see that TLR1, 2, 4, and 5 are the most important TLR component which are responsible for the binding with some different type of the bacterial component. Okay, so gram-positive, gram-negative, and some motile bacteria, and also the GPI anchored some proteins which are available in the parasites. Now we see on the endosomes of these macrophagic cells, we see that on the endosome membrane, we have another type of TLRs are existing, like TLR3, TLR7, TLR8, and TLR9. So these are the another TLR component which are existing for the binding of with the different type of receptors molecule. Like TLR3 is responsible for the binding with double-stranded RNA molecule, which is part of the viruses. TLR7 and TLR8 are the TLRs which are responsible for the binding with the single-stranded RNA molecule, which is also a part of the viruses. And TLR9, which is the part of the binding that is responsible for the binding with the some viral DNA or the bacterial DNA, especially at the CpG I level, which is a part of the DNA. So you know well about the CpG. CpG is the some specific sequences which is available on the surface of the DNA, and it's a part of the bacteria and the viral component, or you can say it's a part of the prokaryotic DNA structure. Now, what happens when the TLR bind to microbe? As I told you, after the identification of the binding, the another event which is carried out by the TLRs, that is, they may start initiating an event or process through which they can be carried out the killing also of these microbes. So, as soon as the TLRs are binded with the microbe, they carried out the so many functions, like they can carry out the secretions of the cytokines or interferons, they carried out the inflammations, they can carry out the phagocytosis of the infected cell, and they also be responsible for the apoptosis of infected cell. So whenever the phagocytosis or the apoptosis are get initiated, so they are responsible for the killing of infected cell, and if the secretions of cytokines or interferon or inflammation is get provoked by the TLR, they enhance the immune response. So inflammation and the secretion is not responsible for the killing action directly, But the phagocytosis and the apoptosis are the directly responsible for the killing action of infected cells. Now, this is summary of the innate response. So, in the innate response, we see that internal defenses are there, in which we have to go for the cellular defense, cellular process of the defense mechanism, which involves the neutrophils, monocytes, NK cell, and TLRs. So, in innate immune system, we have already discussed about the WBC. Now we come to the another very important component of the blood that is termed as 3C, that is cytokines, coagulation protein, or the complement protein. So what are these? Cytokines. Cytokines are some small proteins which are secreted by the cells of the immune system, and they affect the behavior of other cells. They are the signaling molecules, and they are the key players in the innate and the acquired immunity. So cytokines are one of the very important component which are mostly released from the activation of the T cells, and they are the small proteins. They affect the behavior of other cell, signaling molecule, and it is the key player for the innate and adaptive both. So in this figure you can see, these are the cytokine genes which are responsible for the cytokine release. The binding of the cytokines can be take place related to the gene activation, and they initiate the some biological effects. So which cells release cytokines? So cells of the immune system which are responsible for the release of cytokines are neutrophils, when they encounter a pathogen, macrophages, when they encounter a pathogen, TLRs, bind to microbe or the component of microbe, NK cell on encountering a microbe infected cell or the tumor cell, and the lymphocyte when they are activated. So these are the different types, and neutrophil, macrophages, TLR and NK cells are the part of the innate immunity, whereas the lymphocyte is a part of adaptive immunity. Example of cytokines are the interferons, interleukins, and the tumor necrosis factor. So interferons are what? Interferons are some signaling molecule produced by the virus-infected monocytes and the lymphocyte. They are the known as the key antiviral protein, and the function is to interfere with the virus replication. Warn the neighboring cell that a virus is around. If we did not have interferon, most of us may die of influenza virus infection. So this is the last line you can focus on. If we did not have the interferons, most of us may die of influenza virus infection. So this is the interferons which are having in your system, and they are responsible for the generation of huge amount of antiviral protein. And these antiviral components are responsible for the that killing action of so many viruses, and that is how they can get protected from the very common virus like influenza. So these are the some animation in which you see that if one cell is get infected with the virus, now they give signals to the other cell that I am get infected. So this is what the signals are get released after the infection of a single cell to other cell that I am get infected, and you start preparing for some antiviral protein. Now with that, our other cells are start having the antiviral state, and this antiviral state is going to get formed. Now whenever this that virus start replicating and start infecting the other cell, the cells are not get infected because they undergo an antiviral state. So whatever the cells which can enter inside the main system, they totally eliminate by the antiviral state, and finally they are being protected, and this is how the interferons subsides the those viral component before they carried out the infection. So in this way, the pre-warned cell are able to clean with the viruses, and this is how interferons kill the viruses. So the host proteins, the induction is can occur by the this interferon alpha, and now the virus double-stranded RNAs are get formed, and this may carry out what? They may carry out the activation in which inactive host proteins are get formed, and the cascade of events are get initiated, and which may be related to the inhibition of host protein synthesis, and through which the virus are not get replicated. Okay, so you know where for the virus replication the most important thing is required the host protein, and if the host protein is not being synthesized, the virus will not be get assembled properly, and that is how the virus is not get killed. Interleukins. Interleukins have a huge number, that is number is 1 to 37, not stored inside the cell. They quickly synthesize and secrete in response to infection. They are the key modulator of behavior of immune cell and mostly secreted by T lymphocyte and macrophages. Interleukins are also being done these major processes like proliferation of the immune cell, increase of antibody production, activation of the immune cell, and the inflammation. So the most important function of these interleukins are they are responsible for the antibody production. So you know when whenever the interleukins are released by the, some activated T cells. So these T cells are responsible for the release of these interleukins. Interleukins when reaches to the B cells, then B cells start producing the their antibodies against that infection, and that is how the antibodies production get in the immune system. And they are also responsible for the increase the number of immune cells for fight with the some infectious component. And in this process, whenever the secretion of interleukins can do, they can be get a huge amount of the inflammation also. TNF, that is another very important component of these cytokines, that is tumor necrosis factor. The function they can do, they can clean out cancer, initiate the fever, and also get out the inflammation. So that's all for the today's lecture. Now in the next lecture we discuss about the another C components, that are the complement and the coagulation factors. Okay. See you in the next lecture.